Okay, so Jan, can you tell us about the first races of 2017 at Silverstone and Monza?
Well, Silverstone was like a cold shower for us because I didn't know the new part of the track yet, and Fritz didn't know the track at all. And of course there is the simulator situation where you can try, but both of us, we get sick in the simulator and we don't like it. I like the real thing. So in the race in Silverstone, we were really confronted with that. We messed up the qualifying. Our own strategy just didn't work with the red flag that was there. So yeah, I thought I needed two laps before I could do my fast laps, and that really screwed up qualifying. But later in the race, we saw that the qualifying really didn't matter because we were way too slow. And we know that even if we are last and we are 1/10 slower than the guy in 11th or 12th place, then we are still proud because, you know, the competition is so tight that if we would be like 7th or 8th, we would be extremely proud. In Monza, it looked a lot better. Fritz knows Monza, so we were both much more comfortable. Monza, I've done a million miles there, so that was easy. And in the race, you know, at some point we were running times that were like top three, top five. So I was happy with that. So I'm happy with the progress, but not happy with the end result yet. So we just keep working, and we don't know if we can ever make it in the top six or on the podium. But the trying to get there is so nice that we just love to challenge ourselves and jump in the deep end against all the young boys.
Yeah. And how does it feel to be back at Le Mans?
Oh, it's fantastic. It's fantastic. Not only for myself, but I'm very pleased and proud that we can introduce Rubens Barrichello to Le Mans. And so I'd love to see how he will be introduced, if he's a fan of Le Mans on the Monday after the race. And with Fritz, already when he was my one of my founding sponsors of the Racing for Holland with the domes, you know, when we were here in 2001, he was one of the basic sponsors that helped us to get here. And already since then we said, like, it would be nice to do one day Le Mans together. This day is coming now, so I can't wait to see his face after the first few laps when he's been here. So yeah, it's all a very very happy atmosphere.
And you have a famous new teammate for the race at Le Mans,
yeah.
But he's a rookie driver here. What tips are you giving Rubens for getting a good lap at La Sarthe?
I think just to take it as it comes, and he's managed to work his way up to Formula One and have a beautiful career. He has won 11 Grand Prix for Ferrari. He has driven more Grand Prix than anybody on this planet. So there's nobody with more experience to driving than Rubens. So I don't have to tell him anything. And you know, if he has any questions, I see what I can add. But I don't have to tell him anything. And even my own experience, I try to ignore, because I am a fan of an open mind. So I'd like to jump in the car and then see what we have, you know, and take it as it comes. So yeah.
And what do you think of the LMP2 class this year?
Oh, it's fabulous. It's fabulous. I mean, to see what kind of times that we are likely to do here, that we are going under 3:30, that's the expectation. But already, I recently drove the car in Zandvoort for like a sponsor day with the Jumbo supermarkets. We had a Max Verstappen family day, a racing day. So I drove on a track like Zandvoort, and that was a confirmation for me that the LMP2 is the LMP2 class and today's generation is one of the best things that ever happened to motor racing, because it's a phenomenal car to drive.